Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Wild Buster. My name is Wilfred. I have not been playing this game since the end of last year, so it's been around 2 months or 3 months since I last played. So I'd like to do some gameplay video together with my wife as well, because she is also playing. And also I'd like to talk a little bit about the recent news on the Wild Buster being kicked out from Steam, actually, from the Steam store. So the game is still alive, as you can see, but if you'd like to purchase the game to play it, I'll put a link at the description below, just in case you're interested. Now, I haven't really seen, this is my first time logging in for quite a while back, and so basically I have two kind of like character, and I could like create a new one here as well. Because I've been creating Abandon, I'm going to do a Guardians, but since I haven't been playing the game for 2-3 months, let's see what kind of classes do we have. Well, actually it's the same set of classes, so there's no new classes that is being created since I've last played it. It's only one girl, seriously. They need more girls for the Abandon. Okay, let's take a look at the Guardian. So I think my wife is picking up Guardian as well. I think there is a new class which is called the Hitting Fist, and that's what I'm going to play today. I suppose it's more like a melee kind of thing, so I'm just going to, like Iron Fist, I'm just going to name like a Lace Fist, how about that? There are a couple of things. You can do a weapon that added the benefit of enhancing body strength. Do not suffer from fatigue ever, so you can constantly attack. Nice. Always pose for battle. Can very quickly switch to an attack stance if necessary. So it's like, well, there's quite a few things as well. So it is more like a close quarter combat class as well as the attack class, I think. That's what it does. It does. It's a DPS class, I think. So, okay, let's go. Create. So I need to see what my wife is going to be. Okay, whatever. I'm going to start now. And I can... Hang on, how do I add my wife into the game? Okay, let me just start it. Do you want to play the tutorial? No. I'm fine without the tutorial. Let's roll with it, shall we? Okay, so now... let's talk a little bit about the game being kicked out from Steam. So basically, Incel Game has been caught manipulating votes within Steam, and Steam would like to not to do any business with Incel Games, which include Wild Buster as well as Guardians of Ember. So that is basically the story. I've been reading some of the news in Reddit as well. I think the CEO of Incel Game has been pressurizing the employees to purchase the game, write a nice review, and after that get a refund through the HR, and if they don't do so, they'll get very nasty kind of discussion with the boss. So I don't know, I mean, these are just one aspect of it. It could well be something else. Now that's my wife, by the way, and I have to add her into the game. So well, let me see, let's just add the person. How in the world do I... There's a community. Wow, she's fast. So how do I group up? Party invite. Yep. So that is me. That is Layfist, and that is the Hobo Cup, which is my wife. Ooh, she has a bear. Nice. Okay, so what kind of abilities do I have? I can have activate a double barrage punch that deal amount of physical damage. So there's punch. And then after that, initiate a launching punch. So that is another punch. And the third one is counter and deal knockback. Okay, another punch. And after that, access to octagonal skill. Increase maximum HP health point by 10% armor. So this is more like a buff. And after that, there's an ultimate called Nuclear Fist. Gather resolve and then slam on the ground at target point, dealing a certain amount of damage and knocking an enemy down. So it's very much melee kind of like a hero. How do I... Well, that's very strange to ask my wife, but how do I actually... I kind of forgot how to roll. Ooh, that is the ultimate. Is it? Alright, cool. No, that's a buff. So let's just get some kind of like... there's a story mode to it. Whoa, that's nice. She is playing around with a little bit of her ability as well. So, see a person there. So, I mean, if you have seen my gameplay video before, it's not exactly very, the story is just a story. So let's see. I think I have some bites being stored here. Like, I think you have a bite as well, if I'm not wrong. I have a bumblebee. So let me just get a bumblebee out. And I could actually use a bumblebee as well. Right, so that is okay, so now I'm sort of like, it is like a second nature now. All right, so there's a map. That is a mini map. So I need to talk to the person there and to get to somewhere, I think. All right, so that is the person I need to talk to, who's holding a lizard or whatever it is. Okay, a friend in need, so that is good. And I've nope. Duty is clear the elevator shaft. Okay, subway. Okay, so that is one. I'm just wondering, how do I. Do you remember how do we roll? Is there a button to roll? There's a button to dodge stuff. Do you remember that? I seriously
Space
can't.
bar to jump.
And then there's one that you can sort of like the roll out of danger.
Control.
Really? Oh yeah, that's right. Okay, good. Okay, I'm in business. Okay, let's go into it and let's
Oh,
see.
wait. There's a need to return him.
There's another quest? Wow,
Yeah.
there's just too many quests. Useful weapon. Okay. Okay, I need to accept and get a weapon. That is good. So I've got a weapon in my kind of like a bag. So I equip it. Lovely. So are you ready? Oh, there's another question mark. Why can't they just do everything in one shot? Seriously. Okay, good. Okay, done. It's for real. Let's go in. Elevator shaft. Start. Yay. So yeah, just trying to play this and see whether the interest has been rekindled somehow. Pretty casual game, as I recall. So control is to. Okay, so that I have a level up. Well, this is a very melee class. Whoa, my wife's one is really fantastic. All right. Okay, so that's me. Whoa, I level up really fast, yeah. It's a intense button mashing. Oh, there are two stands. So basically, there are two stands here. I think so. Okay, so there are one stands, boxing stands, or the other one. Okay, so basically, I'm changing stands. What does the stands do? Oh, wow. Okay. Oh wow, so that is the what it does actually. So okay, let me see, right? Advanced Zen, activate a downward power slam, rupturing the ground beneath you, and a flat energy field that deal all target in range. Okay, so this is one of them. Enlightened Ion, activate an ion charge within your suit that disperses a ring-shaped electrical charge around you, making you invulnerable for 1 second. Okay, that's cool. Octagonal wrench. Rapidly strike nearby enemies. Okay, and this is to switch back to another stance. So there are different kind of stands here. Okay, that's fine. So right now I'm in the. Okay. Got you. So I think one is more AoE kind of thing. Yeah, my wife is having a lot of fun. Okay, so there are three buttons to press for this stance. Yeah, a bit of lag there. I don't know why. How's your pet class?
Still trying
to get a hand out of it. So I'm trying to understand. Alright, so okay, so there are some. Before we go in, let's see what happened. I've got some gear. I'm like, hang on a second. How to open the inventory again?
I
is it? How about character? P. Why P for character? Seriously. Okay, so I'm almost naked, so it's good to put on something. Alright, so that is really cool. I don't really have any. Okay, so that's fine. Don't have anything else. Weapon wise, I don't know, nothing much. There are some skill points as well. So Ascender. Oh wow, it's different from what I'm seeing, because last time they used to have quite a lot of skills, but maybe it's a new class. Very strange. Do you get a skill point increase as well?
Yeah.
Yes, your. Yep. So I think, well, I don't think there are any other option than to upgrade my combat enhancement. And I have skill point 1 of 3. Then what happened to the rest of it? Okay, so next one I can't really do until I'm level 5 and above. Thank you very much. I've got like 3 points here. What am I going to do? Very strange. Oh no, hang on a second. What am I doing? So it's the interface here. So there are two type of, as always, there's a trade-off between one to the other. So I'm not going to do too much in this video on what is what here. So I think what I'll do, I'm just going to randomly add something here. Maybe the, I think I quite like the Enlighten as well. Well, let's do that one, and I quite like this one as well. Let's do that one. Done. 3 points. I'm sorted. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 5 is the palm tree. Okay, so I've got my ultimate there. I'm already just waiting for my wife to get sorted. I have also come to a realization there's no point, like, you know, disenchanting things too much. So there is. Yeah, where's the person? You can sell it from here, is it? Okay, so that is the part that I can sell stuff like this one here. I mean, I can disenchant it for something, but really, I realized that it's not really pawn. Maybe now there's a pawn. Before that, isn't. Is it okay if I go in? Yeah? Alright, so I'm just initiating the battle. Let's go in. So this is the booter. Oops. It seems the same, right? Is it not? Was it like that before, last time? Is it a new boss or not? I can't quite remember, actually.
Look at my pet.
Yeah. What happened to her? Well, this, whatever this is, this class is quite doable. That's for sure. Alright, so that's done. Wow, it's a lot easier than before, actually. This is a very durable class. Let's see what kind of thing I have. I've got a rare item, so that's good. I've got a rare chest item, maximum HP plus 3%, vitality plus 3. Okay, so I'm like, I'm done. Very interesting. I don't have mana problem. Do you have mana problem? I remember last time we used to like really have to pump mana all the time. They must have changed it somehow as well. Huh, we don't really run into mana problem, is it?
No.
Very strange. We used to have that problem before. So, let's see. Complete. And the next quest is going to be... next quest, just the next quest. Should we do another one for the video? Just, okay. I think it's go back right in, maybe. So this is the next one, just start it. So yeah, I've been thinking, is Steam very too, like, you know, too harsh to incel games? or not, because yes, they have been manipulating votes, and I do not know the extent of the so-called manipulation. But I don't know whether there's a first warning or it's just one of those things that they have decided to punish a publisher and just make a statement out from it. And but I mean, I felt that they should be I felt that they should just have another way to punish instead. Because it is so important to get a good rating in this game, as you all know. Without a good rating, you can't sell the game in Steam. You have to be positive, very positive, overwhelmingly positive, right? So, and usually our behavior is sometimes governed by how you're being measured. And in this case, the measurement is, in a sense, the measurement is the rating itself. So in a way, it's rather unfortunate that they're being caught and they're being kicked out from it. What would I have done had I been, kind of Steam? I think maybe what I'll do is that, maybe just give a chance, right? I would say, maybe you have to sort of like just delete off some of these comments created by the employee. I feel that they should do it that way instead. And after that, don't do it again. Or it could be a fine somewhere, or a temporary kind of like ban somehow, maybe ban for a couple of months rather than permanently. I mean, that's how I feel. I mean, that I'm pretty sure there are games out there that will spend money purchasing services to just create positive review in Steam. I mean, I'm pretty sure of it. It's just that they're being caught, I think. So anyway, that's how I feel. And would I still recommend this game or not? I don't know. I don't know whether there are a lot of progress in terms of the what is being created. The content wise, it's very hard for me to say, because if I look into currently what is in this game right now, I'm getting a heal from someone. Ooh, my wife heals me. That's so excellent. I don't know whether I'm seeing the the improvement content wise so far. I mean, there's only one new class for the last 3 months, so I don't know whether it's something that is meant to be a game that would keep new content like they say or not. So it's hard for me to judge right now, but I think as and when I see more content being created, I think for this game, that I think the confidence level would be a little bit better. So let me just sell off some of these things first, because I don't really need all this stuff here. Right, sell. I mean, it's still a very casual game, don't get me wrong. It's still kind of fun to just go in there. Keep the refugee cloak though. I think you can turn in. I think it's still quite a fun game that you can just go and play once in a while. Pretty casual as well. Yeah, okay. So okay, one of the stands, the boxing stands, is dodge chance by a certain percentage and damage by a certain percentage. The other one is actually maximum HP and armor. So if I want to be more tanky, I'll go for the octagonal stands. So ready? To jump in, yeah. I'm just asking my wife if she's ready. So, but if you have a friend, it's actually pretty nice to play together. Is it one of her favorite ones? She loved the cutscene, so I cannot skip it. Is it the same boss? I can't remember all these bosses, to be honest. Where in the world is that? Okay, let me pop my ultimate, and after that, Yeah, it's just the second button is not that responsive. Oh wow, it's okay, help yourself. Hey, it's quite good to have my wife that's healing me actually. So with a healer, it's actually rather rather straightforward. I always been wondering why my health is always full back up kind of thing. And I really don't have mana problem, it's so strange. Because I used to have a lot of like a mana issue. Very strange. So there's another kind of like item upgrade, which is the, you know, the yellow one is better than the blue one, of course. So that's pretty cool. Now, so I've done the boxing kind of stance, and I think I'll continue doing that. There is a, I think I'm just going to default one first. So that is all the points I have. Maybe I'll do one more, last one for you guys, and after that I'll lock off, and you know, I'll give an update as and when I get to higher level, I guess. Right now, what level am I? Let's take a look. I'm level 7 founder. Alright, level 7. I mean, you know, to be honest, I mean, getting level up quite fast is actually part of the fun, I think. It's just too many words there. Okay, so that's yet another one that is, well, we are supposed to go somewhere, is it? To talk to somebody? Let's see. I'm seeing an arrow asking me to go somewhere. No idea. Ah, that's the one. So, it's... it's a flying thingy. So that is the... I have to head to Crosslink. You ready to go to Crosslink? I will just show you guys another kind of like, you know... another region that's called Crosslink. So I'm heading there. No, you have to talk to someone, just mount up, and then after that you talk to someone. Let's see, and after that, that is the person over there. Well, basically it's always the same, they introduce you from one end of the map to another end of the map, and after that you get more quests so as to do more bosses, and it's just about it. There aren't really a lot of quests to it. I wish they don't overdo the whole questing thingy, because it's not really that... you go, alright, you just talk to a person there, and then go to select destination, go Crosslink, yeah? That is about it. What mount am I? I'm having a mount here that looks rather interesting. I actually got this one from my previous character. One of the reward as you complete certain milestone, you'll get that. And someone is queuing up for something, actually. What are they doing? Seriously. I mean, the artwork is pretty decent as well, I must say. There's no complaint on that one. The artwork is pretty nice. It's just sometimes the questing is still a little bit strange, to be honest. You got a quest already, right? Yeah, so let's just... Oh, not this one. This is level 50 and above. I've got a character that's level 50 though. That's level cap. So that is the maintenance route, 32, and just start this mission. Alright, just another one. Jump right in. And then there's yet another helicopter. Dropping us into a zone. So now I should have better gears. Way better gear, right? So. So let's see. Wow, is it the same pet that you have? Oh, you have a different pet, is it? What pet is the. Ooh, wow. Yeah, my wife is trying out something different here. I'm not quite sure whether I've seen all these mobs before or not though. Is it new? It could well be. Yeah, just the hold and charge button is a little bit clumsy, to be honest. Iron Fist here. So I could actually swap around my, you know, ability, but I don't know, they must have made it easier. So now it's like Wow, very strange. Yeah, I don't really like the AoE. It definitely is not responsive at all. It's just very hard to execute. Yeah, it's very hard. You have to hold it somehow. How about this one here? Okay, so this is punching. Where is my stamina actually? Oh, there's a stamina button there. So I'm trying out a different build here and see whether it's any fun or not. Well, it's just that sometimes I click the wrong button. I take a mech hit. Oh wow! Yeah, it's so easy to click the wrong button for me at least, somehow. Wrong side! Wow, there's a pet there. Looks really cute. Okay, I've got like a rare item. There's quite a lot of items here. Let me just do it later. Well, definitely seems to be easier than before. They might have nerfed it a little bit. Okay, so that is my Iron Fist. Well, there's a lot of skull around me. I don't know what in the world is this. Okay, so there's a negative condition against me, I guess. Ah, there's a... Wait, let me take care of this while my wife do something else. So this is a rather decent AoE, I must say. The sound effect is weird though. Don't need that. Yeah, I mean I think I get it now. It's just a bit of like AoE management. Which is very effective by the way. Ooh, don't get. So I'm level 10. I think there must be something. Yeah, just a gameplay. Third boss coming along. It's rather fun actually, yeah? I must say, after not playing this game for a while, it's good to play something that is less tedious. Yeah, I mean, you know, it's just, in general, just fun, I guess. Don't have to be too difficult. I mean, it reminds me of the good old Marvel Heroes. I mean, you know, Marvel Hero wasn't that tedious anyway, most of the time. And sometimes that works for people. Okay, so that is done. Burn my ultimate on that. Let's see some of the loot I have, shall we? Wow, looks really cool. Wow, what on earth are these? Soldier tier is a higher tier than recruit. I'll use that one. Soldier boots, soldier rocket. So I'm using soldier right now. This is a rare items. Get a soldier. Why not? Soldier. Yay, soldier. Then I have the, so this one can sell. So normally I just like sell all these things right there. There's no point in trying to craft anything here. Well, at least that was, I mean, if it was a yellow one, I'll keep it for, you know, later to disenchant. But for the, or this what? Dissemble, yeah. All right, so that is done. I think I'm just going for a heal here. Just a normal one. Just heal that a bit. Okay, I'm done. You ready? Right, let's do it. So, this is the... Fellock. is the guy called in Marvel Heroes? The metal guy? No, it's not. Forgot it. Yeah, it's a little bit clunky. It's very hard to control certain thing. Hey. Well, I think I have to move a little bit. That's done. Whoa, they have definitely nerfed down the mobs a little bit. So that is the one of the material used for crafting for some of the higher tier stuff. There are more skill points here and there, and I hope you know, you enjoy this short gameplay video. My wife and I just you know, play a little bit. Whoa, look at your tiger. It looks weird, man. Look at the what's that? It's not really a lion and sort of like, you know, not really a tiger. Oh, hey, there's a pet as well. Donkey. Oh man, that is one of the funniest thing. Where do you get a pet?
It's a drop.
You have a pet?
Yeah.
Congratulations. Donkey. Anyhow, okay, I have a lot of fun. Just, you know, something different from what I usually do. And you guys have fun too. If you are still playing Wild Buster, let me know how you guys getting on these days with this game. So I'll see you next time. Goodbye.